Thank you. Let's learn the books of the Bible, the books that you should know. Let's learn where they are, hide them in your heart. Yeah. Let's learn the books of the Bible,
books of the Bible.
The books that you should know.
That's
Let's learn
right.
where they are, hide them in your heart. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy.
Say Joshua.
Joshua, Judges, Ruth, 1st and 2nd Samuel, 1st and 2nd Kings, 1st Chronicles, 2nd Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah.
Keep going.
Esther, Job, and the Psalms, Proverbs, Ecclesiastes. Song of Solomon, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations. Of the Bible, the books that you should know. Let's learn where they are, hide them in your heart. Let's learn the books of the Bible, the books that you should know. Let's learn where they are, hide them in your heart. Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, Acts, and Romans.
1 Corinthians, go.
1 Corinthians.
What? Second Peter.
First Peter, Second Peter.
Say First John, Second John, Third John.
First John, Second John, Third John.
Scream Jude.
Jude. Revelation.
Let's learn the books of the Bible, the books that you should know. Let's learn where they are, hide them in your heart.
Yeah.
Let's learn the books of the Bible,
books of the Bible.
The books that you should know.
That's
Let's learn
right.
where they are, hide them in your heart. Let's learn the books of the
not coming down.
I told you so.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Journey Today Show. My name is David.
And I'm Casey. Hey, David, what ever made you think that we could shout a giant wall down?
Shout the wall down? No, Casey. You're mistaken. Everyone knows you can't just shout a wall down. I was trying to shout and trumpet the wall down.
Okay. Let me rephrase that. Whatever made you think that we could shout and trumpet a wall down?
Oh. The Bible. In the book of Joshua, chapter 6, that's what the Israelites did.
Oh, you mean the story of Joshua and the walls of Jericho?
That's right. You see, in the Bible, God led the Israelites across the Jordan River and into the Promised Land. But there was just one thing standing in their way. It was the enemy city of Jericho, which was this big city with a giant wall surrounding it. No biggie, though. Joshua and the army of Israel just shouted at the wall and blew trumpets, and it fell down.
Actually, I think there was a little more to it than that.
You know what? Now that you mention it, I think you're right. They had way more people than us. That's probably what made the difference.
I don't think that was it.
Yeah, you're probably right. It's probably because they were yelling in a different pitch than us.
No, please, for everyone else's sake, just stop. Yelling like that might make someone go deaf, but it's not going to knock a wall down. You know what? Maybe we should just read the story and find out for ourselves. So let's do this. In just a second, press pause on the video and read the verses on the screen. While you're reading, see if you can figure out what knocked the wall down. When you're finished, press play and join us back here.
Welcome back, everybody. Isn't that such a cool story?
It really is. And I think verse 16 kind of gives us the answer to the question about who or what knocked down the wall. It says that Joshua told everyone to shout, "The Lord has given you the city."
That's right. You see, it wasn't the shouting or the trumpets that knocked the wall down. It was the Lord. But that doesn't mean that Joshua and the Israelites didn't have a part in it. God told them exactly what to do, and they did it. They didn't turn away from his directions, and because of that, God knocked the wall down and gave them victory over the city of Jericho.
Hey, you know what? That actually gives me an idea for a challenge that involves our friend, Buddy Bot. All right, here's how it works. David, you have to make Buddy move all the way across this 2x4 until he knocks over this wall of cups. But you have to go straight. If you turn to the right or to the left, Buddy will fall off the board.
And into a boiling pool of hot lava.
No, the insurance company said no to the hot lava.
And into a pool filled with robot-eating sharks.
No. We don't have the budget for that. He's just going to fall onto the desk.
Where he could possibly get a small splinter or dent.
No. Well, wait. Okay, I guess that is possible. But to make it more challenging, you have to navigate Buddy while facing in the opposite direction and looking into this tiny mirror that I've attached to these sunglasses.
Oh, man. That really does make it more challenging, but I think I can do it.
I think you can too. When Buddy knocks the wall down, the challenge is over and you win.
All right, let's do it.
All right, David, are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, in 3, 2, 1,
go!
Come on, Buddy! Oh, you're doing so good.
He was so close. Okay, one more time.
Right.
One more time.
You're almost there.
All right. Yeah. 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 We did it! Nice job, Buddy!
Nice job. That was incredible.
Thanks, Casey.
And you know what? That kind of gives us a picture of what God told the Israelites earlier in the book of Joshua before they even got to Jericho. It's our Bible verse for today. It says, "Be strong and brave. Make sure you obey the whole law my servant Moses gave you. Do not turn away from it to the right or the left. Then you will have success everywhere you go." Joshua 1:7.
Oh, okay, wait. I have a question about that verse. So it says, "Make sure you obey the whole law my servant Moses gave you." What law is that talking about?
That's a great question. It's not actually just one law. It's 10. We know them as the 10 commandments. Those are God's 10 ultimate instructions for us to live by. In fact, let's take a look at what they are. Commandment number one, put God first.
Number two, worship God only.
Number three, use God's name with respect.
Number four, remember God's day of rest.
Number five, respect your parents.
Number six, don't hurt other people.
Number seven, be faithful in marriage.
Number eight, don't steal.
Number nine, don't lie.
And number 10, don't wish for other people's stuff.
You see, the key to the Israelites' success against Jericho is that they followed God's instructions exactly. And that's what God wants us to do too. When we turn away from God's commandments to the left or to the right, we fall into sin. But when we walk straight towards God and live the way he wants us to, he can knock down any obstacle that gets in our way.
Hey, you know what? That makes me think of a question. Which of the Ten Commandments do you think is the hardest to follow? Why do you think that? Press pause
and discuss.
Welcome back, everybody. God gives us these commandments because he loves us and wants us to live the best life ever.
You got it. And when we follow God's instructions, we show him that we love him back.
Yeah, but here's the best part. Unfortunately, we all turn away from God sometimes. Instead of doing what God wants us to do, we turn to the left or to the right, and we fall into sin. But instead of landing in a giant pit of hot lava,
Or a pool with sharks,
instead, God offers us his grace. He sent his son Jesus to die on the cross for us. And now, when we go to God for forgiveness, he wipes our sins away. Then he picks us up and puts us back on the right path.
And that is the best news ever.
It sure is. Hey, everybody. Thanks for joining us today. Be sure to join us again next week.
Yeah, we'll see you then. Bye, everybody.